We are seeing the topic called integration. Up to last class we have finished a subtopic called indefinite integration, which was very lengthy. So from today we'll be starting another topic in integrals known as definite integrals or definite integration. Before taking up this topic, we need to remember an important theorem, which is known as fundamental theorem of integral calculus. Before telling the theorem, earlier I said integral is nothing but antiderivative. Antiderivative ka dusra naam primitive. So now we shall go for the statement. What is the statement? F of x be a continuous function defined on closed interval a comma b, and capital F of x be the primitive or antiderivative of f of x, such that, or that is, integral of f of x dx is equal to capital F of x. That means if we find the derivative of this particular capital F of x, we need to get f of x, small f of x. Then how can we define this particular definite integral over closed interval a comma b? Means integral of a to b f of x dx is equal to f of b minus f of a. Therefore integral a to b f of x dx is equal to f of x integral a to b from a to b f of b minus f of a. So just as a formal I am telling this theorem, but before going for the problems, what this particular theorem tells, I'll be telling. If suppose a question is given to you, find integral of 2 to 3 x square dx. A question might be given to you, integral 2 to 3 x square dx. Here this particular 2 we call as a lower limit and this particular 3 we call as an upper limit. So what we need to do means, first of all, forget for some time there are limits. That means forget some time that there is a lower limit or an upper limit. Find integral of x square. Integral of x square means x cube by 3. X cube by 3. You write the value of that particular integral. And what are the limits are there? Those limits you write like this. Here 2 and here 3. Therefore, after writing the limits, substitute the upper limit. That means 3 cube by 3. Substitute the lower limit. It is nothing but 2 cube by 3. So 3 cube by 3 means 27. 27 by 3 minus 8 by 3. So 27 minus 8 means definitely what it will happen? It becomes as 19 by 3. So here once again I am telling, x square is referring to our the function small f of x. A is referring to 2 and B refers for 3. And here if you could observe carefully, f of x, capital F of x. Capital F of x is the function which is obtained by integrating x square. So capital F of x means x cube by 3, and here lower limit refers for 2 and b refers for upper limit. That means here 3, and later F of b, that means substituting b value. B value means here 3 value in the given function. That means 3 cube by 3 minus 2 cube by 3. So final our net result is 19 by 3. This is the application of fundamental theorem of integral calculus. Now we shall be seeing some more problems based on this pattern. Right, now we shall be seeing some very short answer questions as well as short answer questions based on this basic model. Basic model means here problems based on fundamental theorem of integral calculus. Right, if suppose a question is given to you, it's a basic question, integral 0 to pi by 2 cos x dx for us. Just I suggest you to write the integral of cos x. You people know what is the integral of cos x. Integral of cos x is always sin x. After writing the value of sin x, after writing the value integral of cos x, that is sin x, you put a bracket like this and here 0 to pi by 2. That means if you could observe carefully, I will tell this as small f of x, this as a capital F of x. So it is looking like a f of x from the limits a to b, from the limits a to b. As per the definition, what it is telling, we need to write as f of b minus f of a. Capital F means what here? Sin x. B means what here? Pi by 2.
So I need to write sine pi by 2 minus f of a. Minus f of a means sine 0. But sine pi by 2 value is always 1. Sine 0 is 0. So 1 minus 0 will always be 1. Therefore, finally what happens? Integral of 0 to pi by 2 cos x dx will always be equal to 1. It's a basic problem.
Right. Now we shall be doing some algebraic function ka integration. That means here definite integration. So here again directly I am writing, I won't be writing all these things. 4x cube means 4 will be outside, x cube ka derivative, x power 4 by 4, and here 3x square ka derivative, x cube by 3, minus 2 into x ka derivative, x square by 2, and integral of dx means x, and this is capital F of x. Just now I had shown like this, capital F of x, and limits from where to where? 0 to 1. So before that 4 gets cancels, 3 gets cancels, 2 gets cancels. So whatever function remains, x power 4 plus x cube minus x square plus x from the limits 0 to 1. So definitely I need to substitute upper limit, and later I need to substitute lower limit, and then I need to subtract. So that means if I substitute upper limit, 1 power 4 plus 1 cube minus 1 square plus 1 minus of, I need to substitute 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. So definitely it will be 0 only. So what happens again here, 1 and 1 will be getting cancelled. Because minus 1 square means here minus 1. So 1 power 4 is 1. 1 cube is 1. So 1 plus 1 will always be equal to 2. I think you followed this one.
Right. When coming to this problem, now slowly we are going for some twisted problems.
Integral of 0 to pi by 4 tan square x dx. We doesn't know the derivative of tan square x. Sorry, we doesn't know the integral of tan square x. As we doesn't know the integral of tan square x, definitely we can convert it in terms of a known function, so that for that function I can have a integral. So what I'll be doing means, integral of 0 to pi by 4 tan square x. Tan square x means I can write as secant square x minus 1 dx, because secant square x minus tan square x is always equal to 1. So what I'll be doing, integral of 0 to pi by 4, this I can write as secant square x dx minus integral of 0 to pi by 4 dx, that is equal to integral of secant square x. Integral of secant square x is what? Tan x, right? And here from the limits 0 to pi by 4, and integral of dx is what here? X, and from here limits 0 to pi by 4. I think you people are clear. So I need to substitute the upper limit in this function, minus lower limit in this function. So tan pi by 4 minus the tan 0 minus of, here also upper limit minus lower limit substitution. So pi by 4 minus 0. So I think tan pi by 4 is 1, 1 minus 0 is 1, and here pi by 4 minus 0 is pi by 4. So our answer is 1 minus pi by 4.
I think now you are finding easy, because we practiced a lot of questions in indefinite integration. Just whenever definite integrals are given to you, just find the normal integral. After finding the normal integral, we need to substitute the upper limit minus lower limit. That means we need to substitute upper limit, lower limit, and subtract both the things, right? So these are the very, very basic level questions. Next we go for some higher level questions. We shall see some short answer questions. Thank you.
Now we shall see some short answer questions of 4 marks. The very first question is, integral of 0 to pi by 4 under root of 1 minus sine 2x dx. So that is equal to, here 1, before writing this, I think by this time you might be getting an idea how to write this particular kind of integral. 1 minus sine 2x means I can write as
2 sin x cos x and here dx. So later integral of 0 to pi by 4 under root of 1 means we can write as sin square x plus cos square x. So what happens? Sin square x plus cos square x minus 2 sin x cos x and here dx. So later what happens? That is equal to integral of 0 to pi by 4 under root of, if you could observe carefully, this is sin x minus cos x whole square. So sin x minus cos x whole square and outside is dx. Now later what happens? This square and 2 will be getting cancelled, and we know that root is there, means plus or minus might be coming. So for my convenience, what I'll be doing for avoiding that plus or minus, I'll be putting modulus. That means integral of 0 to pi by 4, I will put modulus of cos x minus sin x dx. Now later I'll be continuing here. That is equal to, here if you could observe carefully, 0 to pi by 4, 0 to pi by 4, and the interval is 0 to pi by 4. In the interval 0 to pi by 4, always cos x is greater than or equal to sin x. Cos x is greater than or equal to sin x means when you subtract sin x from cos x, definitely the result will be positive. So we can stop writing this modulus. So what happens here? Continuation I am doing. That is equal to integral of 0 to pi by 4 modulus of cos x minus sin x means cos x minus sin x. What is the reason here? Always, since cos x is greater than or equal to sin x for all x belongs to closed interval 0 comma pi by 4. This reason you should mention. Now integral 0 to pi by 4 cos x minus sin x, this can be written as integral 0 to pi by 4 cos x dx minus integral 0 to pi by 4 sin x dx. Now integral of cos x sin x, and from where to where limits here? 0 to pi by 4 minus integral of sin x minus cos x, but one minus is there, so this becomes plus. So what happens? Cos x from the limits 0 to pi by 4. Now here substitute upper limit, sin pi by 4, sin pi by 4 minus sin 0 plus cos pi by 4 minus cos 0. So sin pi by 4 means 1 by root 2, sin 0 is always 0. Cos pi by 4 means 1 by root 2, and cos 0 will be 1. Therefore 1 by root 2 plus 1 by root 2 minus 1, that is equal to 2 by root 2 minus 1. 2 by root 2 means 2 I can write as root 2 into root 2. So 1 root 2 will be getting cancelled. So finally the result will be root 2 minus 1. I am explaining this one. It's a 4 mark question. Many questions might be there, but I am picking up some few questions and I am explaining. Integral of 0 to pi by 4 under root of 1 minus sin 2x dx. So integral of 0 to pi by 4 sin 2x can be written as 2 sin x cos x dx. So 0 to pi by 4, 1 can be written as sin square x plus cos square x minus 2 sin x cos x dx. So integral 0 to pi by 4, this becomes under root of sin x minus cos x whole square. 2 get will be getting cancelled, but if I remove root, modulus comes. Therefore a minus b whole square or b minus a whole square, one and the same. So I kept as mod of cos x minus sin x dx. But in this particular interval 0 to pi by 4, cos x is always greater than sin x. So cos x minus sin x will always be positive. So I am removing modulus and writing 0 to pi by 4 cos x minus sin x dx. But integral of, so separately integrating, integral of cos x sin x, integral of sin x will be minus cos x, but minus minus becomes plus. So after substituting, finally I'll be getting the output as root 2 minus 1. Right, we shall be seeing a problem, little bit deeper problem. Integral of 0 to 1 under root of x plus 1 plus root x. So we are not having any kind of formula to evaluate this kind of integral. So we need to try for another alternative. How can we do integration? If you could observe carefully, the function is like 1 upon under root of x plus 1 plus root x. So whenever this kind of function is coming or is occurring, we need to get into our mind an idea called as rationalization. So first of all, I'll be doing rationalization of our denominator. So 0 to 1, what is the rationalization factor of this particular thing means? I can write as root of x plus 1 minus root x divided by root of x plus 1 plus root x into root of x plus 1 minus root x, and here there will be dx. So later what happens? That is equal to integral of 0 to 1 root of x plus 1 minus root x dx divided by x plus 1 minus x. So xx will be getting cancelled. Finally, there remains integral 0 to 1 root of x plus 1 minus root x dx. Now we need to do integration separately. So here I'll be doing, that is equal to what happens, integral 0 to 1 root of x plus 1 dx minus integral 0 to 1 root x dx. So what happens, integral 0 to 1 root of x plus 1 dx means x plus 1 whole power 3 by 2 divided by 3 by 2, because here 1 by 2 is there. 1 by 2 means 1 by 2 plus 1 in the power, and in the denominator 1 by 2 plus 1. So x plus 1 whole power 3 by 2 upon 3 by 2, a bracket, and limits are from 0 to 1. Here also x power 3 by 2 by 3 by 2 from the limits 0 to 1. Now I will be substituting upper limit and I'll be substituting lower limits. So what happens? 1 plus 1 whole power 3 by 2 by 3 by 2 minus 0 substituting. 0 means what happens here? I'll keep a bracket like this. 0 plus 1 whole power 3 by 2 is 1 power 3 by 2 by 3 by 2. And here also 1 upon 3 by 2. 0 substituting means it becomes 0. So what happens? 2 power 3 by 2 into 2 by 3 minus 2 by 3. And here minus 2 by 3. So doing calculation. So what happens? 2 power 3 by 2. And I think on the whole I can take 2 by 3 common. If I take 2 by 3 common, what happens? 2 power 3 by 2. I think minus 2. And outside I can put as 2 by 3. I think problem is clear to you. 2 by 3 if I take common, minus 1, minus 1, minus 2, and here 2 power 3 by 2, right? This is also an important question. On this particular pattern, we shall be seeing one long answer question. This question might come for 6 marks. So, based on fundamental theorem of calculus, up till now I covered 1 mark question, later 4 mark question, now 6 mark question, or 2 marks or 6 marks, 4 marks or 6 mark question. So because in your examination there will be very short answer question and long answer question. This problem comes under the category of long answer question. So integral of 0 to 1 dx upon 1 plus x plus x square. So I think I'll write this neatly. 0 to 1 dx upon x square plus x plus 1. So there is no formula in evaluating this kind of function. As there is no formula in evaluating this kind of function, we need to go further than other alternative. We shall remember the indefinite integration problems. Whenever the function is of the form dx by ax square plus bx plus c is there, we need to make this function in the form of some perfect square. We shall try to attempt in making like a perfect square. How we can make means x square plus x plus 1. So x square plus x plus 1 by 4 plus 1 minus 1 by 4. How you got this 1 by 4? Many times I explained. What is the coefficient of x? 1. You divide or make it half. Later what you need to do, you need to make whole square. Whatever result is coming, that result you should add as well as subtract. This many times I repeated, but now also I am telling. So this will become as x plus 1 by 2 whole square plus 3 by 4. So this can be written as x plus 1 by 2 whole square plus root 3 by 2 whole square. So definitely I will be doing, or I will be writing this in a denominator. So 0 to 1 dx divided by x plus 1 by 2 whole square plus root 3 by 2 whole square. Right, if you could observe carefully, again it is of the form dx by, for some time if you think this as capital X, it is looking like dx by x square plus a square, dx by x square plus a square. That means here I am writing integral of dx by x square plus a square. So what is the formula for this? 1 by a tan inverse of x by a. So here a ki jagah mein root 3 by 2. So 1 by a means root 3 by 2 tan inverse of x plus 1 by 2 divided by root 3 by 2. And what are our limits? 0 to 1. So 1 by root 3 by 2 means here I am writing, it becomes what beta? 2 by root 3. And tan inverse of, this can be written as 2x plus 1 by 2 whole divided by root 3 by 2. And what are our limits? 0 to 1, still limits not substituted. Later what can I do? 2 by root 3 tan inverse of, 2 will be getting cancelled. So 2x plus 1 by root 3, and here from the limits 0 to 1. Now I'll be substituting upper limit and I'll be substituting lower limit. So what happens? 2 by root 3 tan inverse, what happens? X ki jagah mein 1 substitute kare to 2 into 1 plus 1, that means 3. 3 by root 3 will be tan inverse 3 by root 3. 3 by root 3 means tan inverse root 3. And later I will substitute 0. If I substitute 0, what happens? 2 by 3 tan inverse 1 by root 3. So finally what happens? 2 by root 3 will be coming tan inverse of root 3. Tan inverse of root 3 means it will be pi by 3. And tan inverse of 1 by root 3 means it will be pi by 6. So 2 by root 3, I can take an LCM 6, so 2 pi minus pi. So finally our answer will become 2 pi minus pi will be pi. So 2 pi divided by root 3 into 6, that means pi divided by 3 root 3. It's a very very important problem asked in one of our CBSE examination. Right? I think you followed. Please copy. Right, now we shall be seeing another pattern where integration can be found by using substitution method. In indefinite integrals also we had seen some problems based on substitution method. On the same lines here also we will be doing, but after substituting a small change will be there. What is that change? Now you can see. Right, 0 to pi by 2, the very first problem, integral of 0 to pi by 2 cos x dx divided by 1 plus sin x whole square. So here what I'll be doing, I'll be putting 1 plus sin x is equal to t. 1 plus sin x is equal to t means cos x dx is equal to dt. Now here what is the change? I said there we need to observe a small change. What is that change means? Whenever we are putting 1 plus sin x is equal to t, we are getting cos x dx is equal to dt. That means this whole function is getting in terms of t. If the whole function is getting in terms of t, means our older values or older limits should also tone down to new limits. how we will be getting the new limits means, when I put x is equal to 0, what happens? T value will become equal to 1. When I put x is equal to pi by 2, what happens? X ki jagah mein pi by 2 substitute kare to 1 plus sin 90. 1 plus sin 90 means 1 plus 1. That means t value will become 2. Therefore, what happens? Integral 0 to pi by 2 cos x dx divided by 1 plus sin x whole square is equal to integral of, when place of x is equal to 0, we'll be getting t is equal to 1. In place of pi by 2 means I'll be getting 2. Cos x dx means what? Dt divided by t square. So integral of 1 to 2 dt divided by t square. Dt divided by t square. That means integral of 1 by t square. Integral of 1 by t square means what? Minus 1 by t from the limits 1 to 2. So after substituting, I need to substitute 2, I need to substitute 1. So what happens? Minus 1 by 2 minus of minus 1 by 1. So minus 1 by 2 plus 1. So value will be 1 by 2. I think you are clear with this particular thing. Right? So we shall go for another problem. Integral of 0 to pi by 4 tan cube x divided by 1 plus cos 2x dx. So if you could observe carefully again, 0 to pi by 4 tan cube x dx, 1 plus cos 2x means I can write as 2 cos square x minus 1. So 1 will be getting cancelled, 1 by 2 outside, integral of 0 to pi by 4 tan cube x divided by cos square x dx. So now we should be very, very careful in solving this problem. So 1 by 2 integral of 0 to pi by 4 tan cube x by cos square x. So what I'll be doing means, here if you could observe carefully, tan cube x cos square x means 1 by cos square x means I can write as secant square x dx. Once again I'm repeating. Cos 2x means I can write as 2 cos square x minus 1. 1 will be getting cancelled. There remains tan cube x by 2 cos square x. 1 by 2 bahar nikala. So 1 by 2 into integral of 0 to pi by 4 tan cube x by cos square x dx. So 1 by 2 integral of 0 to pi by 4 tan cube x, 1 by cos square x means secant square x. Now I think we can go by substitution method. What substitution method is telling? We need to find a function in such a way that remaining part also becomes dt. So for my convenience, I'll put tan x is equal to t. If I put tan x is equal to t, secant square x dx will be equal to dt. So the function whole will be changing in terms of t. As the function is changing in terms of t, our older limits also will become in terms of new limits. So when I put x is equal to 0, t will become 0. When I put x is equal to pi by 4, t will become as 1. So here I am writing that is equal to 1 by 2. When x is equal to 0, t becomes 0. When x is equal to pi by 4, t becomes 1. So what happens? Tan x is nothing but t. But here tan cube is there. So t cube secant square dx means dt. I think you followed. So what happens? 1 by 2 integral of t cube means t power 4 by 4. Our limits are from 0 to 1. So 1 by 2, when I substitute 1, t ki jagah mein 1 substitute kare to 1 by 4 minus 0, that is equal to 1 by 8. I think you are clear. So we shall see some of the recent CBSE questions. After doing these two problems, we shall switch on to the next pattern. Right, if you could observe carefully, integral of 1 to e cos of log x to the base e by x dx. So here what I need to do means, I'll be putting log x to the base e is equal to t, but integral of log x is 1 by x dx is equal to dt. That means function whole will be changing in terms of t. As the function whole is changing in terms of t, our older limits will also change to newer limits. So what I'll be doing, when x is equal to 1, what happens? T value will become as 0. When x is equal to e, our t value will become as 1, because x ki jagah mein 1 rakhe to log 1 is always 0, so t will be 0. X ki jagah mein e substitute kare to log e to the base e is always 1, so therefore t value will be 1. Therefore our problem will become like this: integral 1 to e cos of log x to the base e divided by x dx is equal to integral of, right, when I kept x is equal to 1, I got t value as 0, so lower limit will become 0. When I kept x is equal to e, t value is becoming 1, so our upper limit will become 1. And here log x to the base e I kept as t, so this becomes cos t, and dx by x will become as dt. I think you follow. Dx by x will become as dt. So integral of cos t will be sin t from the limits 0 to 1. I need to substitute. So substituting upper limit, sin 1 minus sin 0. Sin 1 is always sin 1 and sin 0 is always 0. So sin 1 minus sin 0 means it becomes sin 1. I think this is clear. This is also an important problem. I give important symbol like this. Right. When I go for the next problem, integral of 1 to e square dx upon x into 1 plus log x whole square. Right. Now I think anyone can tell you what to substitute. Yeah, it's right. Put 1 plus log x is equal to t. So 1 by x dx will become dt. So function will change in terms of t. So old limit will change to new limits. So when x is equal to 1, when x is equal to 1, t value will become 1 because log 1 is always 0. When x is equal to e square, what happens? 1 plus log e square is equal to t. That means 1 plus 2 is equal to t, because 2 into log e is always 1. So because base is here e only, so t will become as 3. Therefore our problem will change like this: integral of 1 to e square dx divided by x into 1 plus log x whole square is equal to integral of lower limit. In place of 1, I will be writing 1, because when I kept x is equal to 1, I got t is equal to 1. When x is equal to e square means t value I got as 3. And here dx by x will become as dt. So dt divided by 1 plus log x is nothing but t. So it becomes as t square. So integral of 1 to 3 dt by t square. Dt by t square means what? It is looking like t power minus 2 dt. So t power minus 2 plus 1 by minus 2 plus 1. That means t power minus 1 by minus 1. So what happens? Minus 1 by t from the limits 1 to 3. That means minus 1 by 3 minus of minus 1 by 1. So minus 1 by 3 plus 1. So 1 minus 1 by 3. 1 minus 1 by 3 means what here? It becomes as 2 by 3.
Right? This kind of problem we had seen indefinite integration, but here limits were also given. So whenever this kind of problems comes, I said for x we need to add plus 1 and subtract minus 1. So what I'll be doing at the beginning, I consider the given function. So x e power x divided by x plus 1 whole square. So what happens? Plus 1 minus 1 into e power x divided by x plus 1 whole square. So this becomes, this is a, this is b, this is c. So a by c means x plus 1 by x plus 1 whole square. So that turns down to 1 by x plus 1. And b by c means 1 by x plus 1 whole square.
and outside there is e power x. So neatly writing, I can write as e power x 1 by x plus 1 minus 1 by x plus 1 whole square. So we now want to find integral. So what happens? X e power x divided by x plus 1 whole square. So what happens? Integral of e power x into 1 by x plus 1 minus 1 by x plus 1 whole square. So this is f of x, this is f dash of x. So if you could observe carefully, there is a formula e power x into f of x plus f dash x, that is nothing but e power x into f of x. So here I am writing that is nothing but e power x into f of x, that is nothing but x plus 1. But here limits are where to where? 0 to 1. So here also what happens? We need to write 0 to 1. So when I keep 1, what happens? E by 2, 1 plus 1 is 2. And when I keep 0, what happens? E power 0 is always 1. So 1 by 1, that means e by 2 minus 1. So our answer will be e minus 2 by 2. Thank you. This is e beta. This is e. So we finished the class. In tomorrow session, we shall be continuing with properties of definite integral. Don't miss the class.